my name is Paul Martin Merges, and I'm going to be talking about my new body of work called the Sampler Series, which follows the last body of work called California Transplant. So California Transplant was about moving to Oregon, and now Oregon is my home, and so the images and the idea all relate to home, being at home, what you do at home, and that whole idea. The first piece that I'm going to talk about is stay. When you think of home, you think about the things in your home, or I did, and chairs where you sit and you talk with your family and friends. That's an ottoman. The dear refers to a play on words of something that is dear to you, and deer also represent nature and wildlife because there's a lot of it out where we live. These are my favorite flowers. What are they called? They're called shooting stars, shooting star wildflower. I used a lot of collage materials, screen printing. I did some Hammond embroidery, but in this particular piece called At Home Anywhere, I used the Portland Thomas Guide map because a map and location route you to your home and give you a sense of place. There's silhouettes of houses, you know, just continuing the idea of home. And then you can't see it here, but in the background there's names of Filipino foods like pancit and lumpia, I can't see them all, longanisa, adobo. So food also reminds me of home and growing up. I had originally wanted to do embroidery in the pieces, and I tried to screen print them on. So you can see some screen printing, sort of stitching like lines. But then I decided, I took an embroidery class, and I just decided to do hand embroidery, which is a very domestic thing and ties in nicely to, you know, the themes of home and cooking and domesticity, you know. And then there's stars and constellations. The title of this piece is called A Real Piece of Work. And I, you know, use recycled materials. There's some machine embroidery here with these pieces. And then hand embroidery, different kinds of colonial knots and eyelet stitching, chain stitching, all sorts of bouillon stitching. All kinds of different things. It's actually called Brazilian embroidery. It should be called dimensional embroidery because it's 3D, and you can kind of, there's a lot of surface. It sticks out. It's not just flat like cross stitching. This is turkey stitching, and this is eyelet. It's quite dimensional, so I like that sort of 3D. This piece is called Orange Frass, and I cut three panels. These sizes are actually about, if you do quilts, they're about 10 by 12, which is a standard quilt size for making quilt making squares. But then I sewed them together because I wanted to screen print and have a longer piece. In samplers that they used to have young girls do, they would have Bible verses and obituaries and sort of moral sayings to make sure that the girls employed their minds and, you know, were not idle. But instead of using Bible verses, I've used words that I say and phrases that I say all the time. Dude, yes, no oh, yeah. way. Seriously, right on. Oh, yeah.
Go for it.
Whoa, go for it. Love it. I just, what it is.
What it is.
I love 80s music. So those are things that are important to me. These are bouillon stitches, and they kind of reminded me of insect poop, which is called frass. So that's what I called the piece, Orange Frass. The deer sort of also represent life and death because, you know, they fight, but they're a prey animal, and, you know, they fight so that they have the right to mate and, you know, bring forth new life. But then they, you know, they get eaten and, you know, killed and shot all the time too.
Oh my God. Oh. A
little bit of text messaging in there.
This is...
The view never changes when you're behind the leader. And that was the first thing that I put on when I did this one. I machine embroidered this, and I was just thinking about, you know, if you don't have any goals or aspirations and you're always in, you know, behind somebody or following someone, the view never changes. I collaged some pieces on there, and I should have changed the title, but I don't know, I like the view never changes. You can think about that more long-term, like if you look up in the sky, you know, things change on the ground, but when you look up in the sky, the stars are there, and they don't usually move, so the view never changes up there. So the stars are machine embroidered, but this is a stem stitch, and that's machine embroidered, I think it's called a feather stitch. This piece is called Heart, H-A-R-T / H-E-A-R-T. As you can see, there's a deer, the heart, and then the other heart. And again, collage materials from the Portland Thomas Guide, Terwilliger. I spent a lot of time there, Portland. Lake Oswego is near. I live down over here more, off the map. Yeah, I enjoy collaging the materials just because it sort of gives you, you know, your mind a little bit of room to sort of wander, and you can take different things that are happening in your life or in my life and just put them on a paper and kind of arrange them in different ways. It's not that I don't like to draw or paint, but it's just that I can make images come to life a little bit faster when I just sort of grab materials and cut them and, you know, move them around. It's I'm a bit more physical that way.
What do you think about being with Blackfish? Has it been helpful for you?
I think Blackfish is really good because it's a cooperative gallery, and so I can do whatever I want. Like if I wanted to do an installation for my next show, I could. I'm not tied to just working two-dimensionally. So who knows, maybe I'll do three-dimensional fabric installations next. This one's called Country Living, and I do a lot of teaching out at Multnomah Arts Center, and so I wanted to, you know, pay my respects to Multnomah, so that's why it's in Multnomah County. And again, there's the deer and the birds, which represent, you know, nature and being at home in nature, and, you know, another idea of home and just being, you know, happy where you are.